पार्किंग ब्रेक या सर्किट, द नेक्स्ट वन इज डायनामिक ब्रेक या सर्किट। दिस इज द फिगर ऑफ द डायनामिक ब्रेक या सर्किट। द सर्किट ब्रेक पेडल इज डिप्रेस्ड, एयर प्रेशर इज डिरेक्टेड। व्हेन द ब्रेक पेडल इज डिप्रेस्ड, एयर प्रेशर इज डिरेक्टेड टू द टॉप ऑफ द पिस्टन हेल्ड against a spring force in the brake valve. As the piston travels to downward, the combination inlet exhaust valve is shifted off its seat and air enters directly to actuate the rotor chamber. The air pressure entering the rotor chamber actuator against a piston, forcing is to move against a return spring pressure to actuate the hydro retarder valve on the transmission. As the pressure reduces, the piston is forced back and the retarder return to the disengaged state. So this is the way of the dynamic air brake circuit. The next you come. So the next topic is that is air over hydraulic brake. The circuit is shown in this figure and the system consists of the following components. These are two reservoir, dual trade valve, two emergency relay valve, six valve servo and master cylinder, brake assemblies for the wheel, two limiting and quick release valve, dry and slippery road control valve, and last one is brake control valve. This is the following component. Come to the next. The next one is the operation. The two emergency relay valve maintain the proper air pressure of each reservoir. During the use of the brake, when the brake pedal is depressed, air from one of the reservoir passes through the emergency relay valve to the primary section of the brake valve. Air from the other reservoir also flow through the another emergency valve to the secondary section of the brake valve. Air pressure entering the emergency valve causes air to flow out from the reservoir to the servo of the brake circuit. Air pressure in the servo operates the master cylinder. Hydraulic pressure from the master cylinder actuates the wheel cylinder, the brake assemblies. Next is dry and slippery road control. This is a safety measure for the operator to control the braking section of two different road condition. That is, one is dry road condition and second one is slippery road condition. It has been observed that for effective braking, full braking power is desirable at the front wheel while operating under dry road condition. Again, when operating under slippery road condition, a reduction of braking power at the front wheel is desirable for safety operation. This is usually performed manually by the operator through the repositioning of the lever at dry or slippery position. When the valve is at the dry road position, air may pass freely through the control valve, applying the full braking power to the front wheels. When the valve is at the slippery road position, air cannot pass through the valve, and the design is made such that the air pressure actuating the valve servo for the front wheel is reduced to 50% of the normal pressure, thereby reducing the effort by 50%. As the big size dumper used in project yard 10 wheeler dumper. So this is a 10 wheeler dumper. Here is a picture of the 10 wheeler dumper. It's a new design of the dumper family. This one is the 14 wheeler dumper. This one is the deep V type dumper. Now come to the maintenance portion. Maintenance, first one is tire maintenance. Visual inspection is required to make the following: bulging of sidewall, abrupt cutting of tire bead, trapping of stone pieces in between of tire, splicing out of the wear. The abrupt should be repaired accordingly. The next is, after the tire maintenance, next is suspension system maintenance, then transmission system maintenance, hydraulic and air circuit maintenance, and finally dump body maintenance. Here the preventive maintenance schedule are there. What are they? They are basically in 47 numbers. 1. Check engine oil valve. 2. Check radiator water level. 3. Check battery for proper amount of distilled water. 4. Check all air of oil, water, hoses for leakage. 5. Check air cleaner service indicator. 6. Check hydraulic tank oil level. 7. Drain condensation from the fuel tank. 8. Drain condensation from fuel filter. 9. Drain condensation from air tank. 10. Check tire for air pressure and other damage. 11. Check hydro air suspension cylinder for proper exposure. 12. Start engine and operate emergency steering to check from proper operation. 13. Operate waste cylinder and check for proper operation. 14. Check horn, headlight, spotlight, backup light, windshield wiper for proper operation. 15. Check transmission oil level. 16. Listen for any unusual noise for during operation. 17. Check all the gauges, ammeter, air pressure, transmission pressure, engine RPM, speedometer, and water temperature. 18. Check level of final driven compartment. 19. Grease dump body, hinge pin. Number 20. Check level of oil, the differential case. 21. Grease all the component. Check transmission shift, linkage, and cleavage surfaces for the free movement. 23. Lubricate the throttle valve linkage assembly. 24. Solvent clean brothers caps of final drive, fuel tank, crankcase, and the transmission. 25 is fuel filter to be changed and strainer clean. 26. Lubricate drive shaft V joint. Number 27. Lubricate pump drive V joint. 28. Change engine oil. 29. Change bypass filter. Number 30 is change loop filter. 31 is change corrosion resistor element. 32. Grease all the point. 33. Check radiator core and clean it with grease solvent and compressed air. 34. Check drive belt. Check for alternator, water pump, and fan belt tension. 35. Transmission. Change the oil. Change the filter. 36. Check front wheel spindle oil level. 37. Check grease level in the steering gearbox. 38. Check the hydraulic brake fluid reservoir on oil. 39. Grease all the points. 40. Drain water from hot oil or cooler. 41 is lubricant. 42 cooling system. 43 final drive compartment. 44 differential gauge. 45 grease all the points. 46 check roller rail gap, and 47 is check oil cooler and solid. So students, this is the preventive maintenance schedule. So after this, here are the some checklist. For checklist number one is 150-hour maintenance service sheet. So for the mechanical, so here we'll go through the one is wash cleaning equipment, two check and following the engine running, then engine, then air system, next is steering system, oil system, brake system, front and rear wheel, then lubrication system, general and finally running check after the maintenance. Checklist 2 is 300 hour maintenance, that is for 1, 2 and 3 are same for the 150 hour maintenance. Number 4 is air system, 5 steering system, 6 hose system and 7 is brake system. Checklist number 3 is 600 hour maintenance, where 1 and 2 are the same for the 150 and 300 hour maintenance. Number 3 is engine, 4 is steering, 5 is brake system, 6 is front and rear wheel, 7 is lubrication and final is general. And for the checklist 4, that is 1200 hours maintenance. Here 1 and 2 are the same as the before, and number 3 is engine, 4 air system, 5 hose system, 6 brake system, 7 front and rear hose system, 8 lubricant system, 9 is general. And now here some technical details of a damper are given, that are rear end damper. The capacity of rear end damper is 25 ton capacity. Ton. Engine is NT855C310. Brake horsepower 310 at the rate 2100 RPM. Friction horsepower 292 at the rate 2100 RPM. Tire 618-100-254-24 PR tubeless. So in this way, here are the technical specification of a damper, on how or how to write a technical specification are given here. So students, so this is the complete, so this is the complete of the damper notes. For this, for further knowledge, please go through the notes to understand it elaborately. Thank you so much.